Now we have but to wait.
Oh, Lord Ravana, master of the sacred blades, wrath of the colony, conqueror of the world, hear our prayer. Pray grant unto your devoted children the gift of your divine presence.
He comes.
Strength to the colony. Speak and I shall listen.
Oh, glorious general. We have captured intruders and would make unto you an offering of their life's blood.
These feeble fleshlings dared to invade Natlands.
Hear me, Lord Ravana. My companion and I did not come to contest your children's territory. We wished only to learn the reason you wage war against the dragons.
Thou wouldst flirt with death merely to satisfy thy curiosity. Wherefore should the glorious conquest of the Nath concern thee so, Elizen? Mayhap thine own kind struggle against the worms fareth poorly, and thou art desirous of a pact.
We crave no alliance, Lord Ravana. Only peace. We would bring an end to our war with the dragons. Yet so long as they remain embroiled in this conflict with your children, our goal shall remain out of reach. Never before have the Nath risen up in such numbers, and never yet with you at their head. Why do you lead them to war?
Thy question hath no meaning. To live is but to fight. Long have my children waited, gathering their strength in the shadow of thy ceaseless conflict. The Nath would see the Dravanians slain and their territory secured, and by such fervent prayers am I now given form and purpose.
As I feared, your very existence is an obstacle to our goal. Since you are so fond of fighting, we challenge you, Lord of the Nath. And should we emerge the victors, I would have you swear to withdraw your soldiers from Dravanian soil.
Thou art bold indeed to risk thy fleshy hide so readily. Very well. I, Ravana, fourfold master of the blade, do accept thy challenge. But should I emerge the victor, I would have thee swear to serve in mine army till thy last breath is spent. Do you accept?
I do. And I believe the first bout is mine. My lord, thou wilt not break thy word, I trust.
Mine oath is unbending as steel, little goddess. Thy ruse will but add to mine enjoyment.
Myself stronger, mayhap with more crystals.
Be thou god or maid, thou art nothing to me. And what of thee, mortal? Art thou warrior or craven? Feeble companion! Okay.
You do not disappoint, Warrior of Light. Would that I had your skill in battle. I do begin to see why so many place their faith in you. For all his savagery, I do not think Ravana one to break his word. Provided the dragons do not trespass upon Nath lands, they should have little to fear of the Primal's biting blades. We have done well, have we not? Come, let us return to Vidofnir and share these glad tidings.
Once more you achieve the impossible, Bringer of Light. But with every mortal heart that succumbs to fear and fury, another voice is joined to the chorus, beseeching divine succor. At their bidding, warring gods will shake the firmament, and your world will be consumed in the swelling storm of chaos.